Hi, my name is Bogdan. Will you agree that selling IEM for 900 bucks is a bold move? Imagine how special should this model be to collect the profit, especially for the company having their products in the past for less than 500 bucks. So, Dunu-Topsound imagined, decided that they are cool and released their most expensive earphones, DK-4001. Here's their detailed review. The earbuds look quite similar to previous model, but still have got some admirable changes. For example, the nozzle has a lip to improve the fit of ear tips. It sticks from a different angle, the body picked up in size, became more rounded and therefore sits better in your ear. The cable is made of high-end copper and a pure silver conductors from Furukawa company. It is stiff and bulky, however with a nice quality, but its main feature is in the connector that allows you to quickly change jacks. How durable this connection mechanism is by far difficult to say, but it looks and feels reliable. From what is obviously upsetting is the small play that may and will increase over time. On the other hand, a big advantage is that you can easily connect to any port with this variety of caps. Among the shortcomings, it is literally a massive storage of small mechanical elements, a pretty large size that may be uncomfortable, and an obsessive thought of how pointless this idea is. Frankly speaking, most of customers will pick up the right connector on the first day after the purchase and just forget about others, although the price will be paid. In general, I do not find this idea so ingenious. It looks impressive, almost perfectly made, but it's more like a feature for showing off rather than something for daily use. If you are begging to differ and want a similar cable for some other personal headphones, Dunu will soon release the Hulk. 300 bucks and it's yours. But let's get back to the earphones. Among the tech that manufacturer used to achieve a better sound, I will note a housing made of zirconium alloy for holding down harmonic resonances, a dynamic driver with a beryllium diaphragm, ACIS system and a pack of 4 BA drivers from Nose for high frequencies. The most crispy part is about the sound. It is at least truly unusual here, given the fact that the dynamic driver is responsible for 2/3 of all the sound from the headphones, and there's no other way it could have been. Low frequencies are hyped, however their response is not jumpy, bass is massive, having no special advantages in quantity, it sounds very expressive, detailed and realistic. Earbuds don't do any buzzing, their highs turned out to be dense, also there's a beautiful lower bass. Attacks are pretty fast, but only for the standards of dynamic driver, which means you better not wait for speed, kinda like in BA headphones. Mids are emotional and juicy, not dry and hyper detailed as many can expect from hybrid headphones. These are the same mids that you can hear exactly in dynamic models, but instead of mentally highlighting them separately, due to V-shaped frequency response, DK-4001 serves them on a silver platter. There's nice resolution, but the reality is artistically cleaned up. Virtual positioning of the sources is accurate enough, but the scene could be deeper. The mass became more dominant against details. Unfortunately, this world doesn't bring all at once. Treble is perhaps the most arguable thing in the new Dunu. Earphones stop reproducing any sound above 9 kHz. Highs have two peaks in the frequency response. The first one has a turning point at 2 kHz, and for me it's not a problem because it makes music more crispy and virtually increases the resolution. In general, nothing hurts my experience. The second jump you can feel at 6 to 7.5 kHz, that felt extra flashy. Actually, it could have been even worse. I'm at headphones where sibilance caused headache and Dunu luckily are not one of them, but for gentle ears of treble haters, I would recommend to listen a new flagship a bit before buying it. Overall, I found these earphones interesting in a way how they sound. They don't bring any dry or dull emotions, providing instead with a sober, bold and confident bass, realistic and expressive mids, not seamless but still detailed enough and articulate highs. The more we tested them, the more we wanted to keep them in our ears. Actually, I'd love to have them here with me now, but anyway, I've got more for you. So let's compare DK-4001 with its predecessor, DK-3001. The novelty is definitely better in bass, heat has more density and sounds more natural, operating with almost the same depth and slightly more noticeable lower bass. Speaking about mids, 3001 delivers them in a cleaner way. Older model has less dry and cold mids, but the new headphones add a mass, resulting in the fact that DK-4001 loses to DK-3001 in transparency and especially in virtual scene. Highs in both cases are not linear, but the stress that has the first model is the opposite to the second one. Let me explain. When 4001 has a rising sibilance and a slight emphasis to the lower highs, the predecessor sticks to really vital in our life 2-3 kHz, after which a small hump on 5 kHz seems to be neither scary nor biting. Say if I had DK-3001, I would make a change only in 3 cases. The first, you need a greater value for meets and more emotions. The second one, you're a blogger who changes players all the time and is tired of destroying MMCX in his headphones. And the third case is when you have an extra grand and desire to support the company. DK-4001 brings something charming and you can actually feel how company tends to reproduce a sound beyond the dry level of details, drawing beautiful middle frequencies and awesome bass. But even if we remember a high quality cable, with all respect, for $1000 you can buy a previous flagship of the company that is still in a hot spot, plus a nice audio player. For instance, take the X150 and you will get the same cost, but that's already a full setup comparing with the single headphones. If money is not a problem and you dream to be the owner of the earphones for a grand, you should definitely take a look on the new product from Dunu-Topsound. We will place the links where you can buy DK-4001 in the description box below, and if you like this video, hit the like button, also subscribe and ring the bell to stay tuned for more cool content. My thanks for watching and cheers!